Hey everybody! So I had a little bit of a conundrum. I know it's been a while since I've done a video let's play, and I was gonna boot up Duke Nukem. Excuse me, that was awful. I was gonna boot up Duke Nukem again when I realized that I didn't wanna. You know, I feel like we've gotten pretty much everything that we can out of that game, and let me adjust my volume here really quick. And if you guys disagree with that, if you want to see more of that game, I'm more than happy to begrudgingly oblige. But for now, I came across this game called Poi that I've been keeping a little bit of an eye on. I don't know, I haven't been following it too strongly, but I saw that it just came out of early access, and I mean, it looks delightful. Look at it. It's like a little whale thing. Flying a boat thing because whimsy, you know? So, I thought this would be more interesting to do and more fun for me to play, so I'm gonna play it and we'll see how it looks. I tried to resist the urge to play it so that I could jump into this thing fresh, and I did do a previous recording of it that I kind of flubbed a little bit. We'll see if it saved that, but I didn't even get past the intro cinematic, so. Let's see. Yeah, loading new game. We're good. Once upon a time, there were two orphans. Of course, bloody typical. They dreamed of finding adventure in life. Well, yeah, who doesn't? Look at him climbing a mountain, and the other one climbing ledges. So one day they ran away and set forth on a grand journey. Hey. Hey. Wake up. Ooh. Creepy gentleman. Hello there. Sorry to wake you up, but I'm in a bit of a pickle. Aren't we all? I've lost something very important to me in this forest, and I was wondering if you could help me out. Was it your eyes, sir? Because you don't seem to have any. Take a look up there. Can you take a look anywhere? Because you seem to be missing your eyes. See that shiny thing up in the tree? That's the very important item I was telling you about. Oh, well, how about that? I'm not quite the young sprout I used to be, so could you please climb up there and grab it for me? Ooh, Dr. Seuss over here. God, God. Yeah. Now then, which one of you will help me? Alright, so we get to pick the boy kind or the girl kind. Oh, I picked the boy kind. I thought it would give me. Okay, I see. That's alright, we'll be the boy kind. You will? Splendid! You've made this old man quite happy. Hehoo! Owl type over there. I'll wait for you to grab it then. Good luck. So, right away, you'll notice that this game is adorable. Pretty damn adorable. Would you like to change characters? No, we'll stick with this guy for now. Very, very colorful, very stylized, of course. The models aren't great or anything like that. Like, it's not a graphical powerhouse or anything like that, but it looks charming. Press A to jump. Holding down the button makes you jump higher. And also, in case you didn't notice, this game is indeed a platformer, a 3D kind of platformer. And that is great, because you know what? I've been dying for these sorts of things. It's been so long since people have made 3D platformers, mostly because they're tricky to do. Like, make no mistake, they're weird. Platforming is very much a 2D sort of genre. It works best in 2D. 3D games present so many issues with platforming that it's difficult for a lot of people to do. And for a while, you know, people were trying to run along with it, but just sort of stopped because, you know, so much easier to make other things. But I'm glad that people are starting to look into it again with this and Ukulele, because there is a ton. There's just something so refreshing, especially nowadays, about a 3D platformer. Just something simple, something Just something cute, you know? Medallion collected. A helping hand. Took me 3 minutes and 28 seconds. Well, how about that? Hey-hoo! You got it! Could you possibly do me one more favor? That's how they get you. You see, they ask you to do one easy thing, and then they ask you for, you know, all the world, basically. That's what they do with politics when they're putting up signs and stuff, too. They ask you to do, like, one simple thing, like, can you sign this petition saying that you think puppies are adorable and shouldn't be kicked? And you're like, well, yeah. So you sign that thing, and then they're like, oh, one more thing. Let me put this sign up on your lawn. And by then, they've sucked you in, so you're more likely to say yes. That's why they do that. It's annoying. Anyways. Please bring my important item over to my airship. Questionable. Be careful climbing down. Well, at least he's concerned about you. That's good, then. I'm gonna collect these coins because it's a 3D platformer, and I feel I must. So, right away you can see that this game wears its Mario 64 influence right on its sleeve. Doesn't even try to hide it, even a little bit. And that's good.
Hey.
Hi there. Are you training to become an explorer? Oh, you're just helping an old man? I see, See, with an older person looking at this, an older jaded person, this all looks highly suspect, but that's alright, we'll give it the benefit of the doubt. Anyways. Coins! Oh. Jumping out of water, like you do. Let's go ahead and do that. So yeah. So far I haven't really done anything, but... Oh, there you go. Look at that little sprint. Look at him sprint! With purpose! Good lord. This flag represents a checkpoint. If you lose all your health, you'll restart here. Well, thank goodness for that. For a second I was worried. Let's talk. Ho-ho! You're quite nimble! I can't thank you enough for collecting my Explorer Medallion. What's an Explorer Medallion, you ask? Why, yes, I did. Well, it's a bit of a story. Not a long story or a good story, just a story. A long time ago, my wife and I traveled the world together, collecting Explorer Medallions wherever we went. Our biggest adventure was a journey to find a mystical treasure called the Milky Way Globe. One day, however, we got caught in a very bad storm. We tried to hang on, but I hit my head and everything went dark. When I woke up, my wife was missing, and all of our Explorer medallions were gone. Oh. Poor old bastard. I've been slowly trying to find the rest of my Explorer medallions, but it's not very easy for me anymore. Say, why don't you help me find them? It will be quite an adventure. Will you help an old man out? I'd love an adventure, you know what? Hey-hoo! That's the spirit! Let's get going, then! Hang on! Probably get my sister, or whoever that is. I guess she's not... Did it say that she was my sister, or did it say that we were just orphan buddies? I can't remember anymore, which is ridiculous, because it literally just said so, but... That's the state of play that we're in. Right. The important thing is that we're going on an adventure, though. That's what matters. With the Moby ship. I assume that's what it's called. Am I supposed to do anything? No. Yeah, so I think I can talk to her and switch characters. No. We'll be this guy for a little bit more, and then we'll switch characters after that. So, one of the things that you have to take into consideration, or that I take into consideration when looking at a game, like I said, it just came out of early access, like, a little bit ago. And so, this game is just released. It's been, you know, tested by at least a couple hundred people for a little while now. So these little frame rate, where it kind of the frame rate kind of snags a bit, I look at that a little bit more critically now because I know that it's been tested by the community extensively. And it's not the most intensive game, but, you know. So I feel like that shouldn't be there, but that's the risk that you run when you do early access. I think part of it is that people like me, who are bastards, will look at your game a little bit more critically, I think. Like, don't get me wrong, I'm still having fun. Surprised at how high we are? Heh-hoo! Welcome to the sky! Okay. I have a feeling that he thinks that we just came out of a rock. And we have no idea what anything is. From here, we can fly anywhere in the world of Poi. Or is it Poi? I don't know. Take a look over there! That's our first stop, Cozy Canyon. I was on my way to look for more explorer medallions before I noticed the one in that forest. Since you're an official explorer in training now, why don't you take us over there? See the steering wheel in the middle of the ship? Push the bars to turn towards that silhouette. Pay no attention to the compass. It's a little broken right now. Heh-hoo!
His voice is killing my throat a bit.
Got all that? Don't worry, I know you'll figure it out. Now, take us to Cozy Canyon. Will do. Will do with gusto, sir.
Did I push too far? I don't know. There it is. That's pretty cool. I like that. It makes you feel a little bit more like you're having an adventure. Like, it's as gimmicky as they come, but it's a nice little thing that they do. Also, I really dig that the loading times are short. Gets you right into the action. So that's good as well. Okay. Parachuting down. Because why not? Read. This way to Cozy Canyon. Well, thank you kindly. First location, first steps. What do I do here? Alright, so this is telling me all the medallions. Like I said, a very Mario 64-ish. First steps. Oh, okay, so that's just showing me, like, the mission, I guess. Alright. So I think if you look at the last mission there, you can tell when this game was being made compared to when it was released, because I feel like hardly anybody remembers that game. That game was... Not only was it ancient by modern standards, but it also was kind of dumb, if I'm honest. Not like this game, which so far I'm liking quite a bit. Look at you! What are you? I try to stay on the path to avoid running into enemies. Interesting that you call them just enemies. You see, I'm not strong enough to jump on them, Tweedledee. Well, that's because you doubt yourself. Very Mario. But like I said, I've been itching for something like this for a very long time, so I am not complaining. There you go. Nope. Get. Damn. Hey, look at that! Oh shit, they drop coins! Sorry, I shouldn't swear, but They do, look at that. Oh, that's great. Oh, you look so happy. He looks like really chill. Just the chillest turtle around. Next to maybe Crush. Yeah, no, this is good. I'm enjoying this. I say that a lot, I know, but you have to remember that the last few videos that I've made for you people was with something that I very much did not enjoy, so let me have this. So, there you go, got it. Haha. Eat it. So I know that I'm not, like, a designer or anything like that. Like, I don't... Making games is not my forte. Hell, playing games is barely my forte. But there are a couple of things that I'm noticing here that I... You know, that I... I'm sorry, I lost my words for a second there. There are a couple of things that this game is doing that I can talk about that I think are comparatively interesting. Look, if you notice when I jump here, I have like this one shadow, right? And then when I jump, I somehow spawn a second shadow. I just watched an Extra Credits video, and if you don't watch any of their stuff, it's highly recommended. Extra Credits is great. And they were talking about like user interfaces and all that sort of stuff. Well, I need a shovel for that. And they were talking about with 3D platformers, the drop, this is, you know, the drop shadow, which is that thing, to help you gauge your jumps. And I remember the first time I really noticed that. In fact, I'm not sure how I ended up here. I'm scared of heights. Please be careful and avoid standing too close to narrow cliffs. Tweedledee! Jeez. He's... I couldn't think of a clever name for them, but... Anyways, yeah, the first time I noticed them, I want to say, was PS2 era. When I noticed their utility. And I can't remember why I noticed it, but it was just one of those things. I think because PS2 was like when people started saying, you know what, we have the power to make proper shadows now, we don't need these drop shadows. And so some people kind of lost sight of why they're so important in these types of games. And I think that's part of the reason why they fell out of favor, if I'm honest. It's because people just stopped bothering to make them work. I mean, they barely worked as it was. Oh. Nice. So that's good. But yeah, drop shadows are cool. That's my point. I have points to make. I just realized that I wasn't really paying attention to what I was doing, but I seemed to have gotten in the right place. Probably take better advantage of the sprint. Oh, look at this guy. What do you think? Oh shit, he hurt me. I don't know if I can. No, I'm. I'll let you live. That's fine. Oh shit, he really wants me dead. Yay, the windmill is up and running again. I wonder why this windmill needed power anyways. That's a good question. One further wonders why this windmill has platforms on it. But, you know, video games, I guess. Let's get this medallion. Gotcha! Also, if you were wondering, my point with the drop shadows was that the platforming is good. It feels nice. A little bit clunky, but overall, really, really good feeling game. Welcome back, Explorer. I have something to show you. Come here and take a look. Let's take a look. While you were gone, I happened to dig up some of my old explorer tools. Some tools will help you navigate levels, others will give you more ways to explore. Of course, you'll need to give me some coins before I give them to you. Even a master explorer such as myself needs to eat. Hehu. Makes sense, makes sense. Take a look. lets you see things from far away, telescope. I feel like I don't need it. Makes it easier to navigate levels and find secrets. Increases the maximum number of coins you can carry. So how many coins do we have? We have 100. Used to dig up fossils, presumably that gives you more monies. Lets you take pictures and document your discoveries, that'd be good. Automatically grab nearby coins and collectibles, and a permanent extra heart container. Ooh. So, I'm thinking, apologies for that lip smack, I'm thinking that if I can, that I'll probably buy this big wallet. Okay. Big wallet lets you carry so many more coins. Not just more coins, but so many more. Just talk to me again if you'd like to buy an explorer tool. Well then, get going. Explore with gusto. But let me buy one more thing. Let's buy the... Well, I can only buy like either the telescope or the compass, and I'll go with the compass. Will appear as a bar at the bottom of the screen. It will show you the direction of characters and secrets in the level. It's quite useful, one would hope. To use an explorer tool, use LT and RT to select the tool, then press Y to use it. Gotcha. We probably won't end up using it all that much, but it'll be good to have. Let's go ahead and switch to a Zelady type. Alright, indeed. Do we keep going to Cozy Canyon? Probably. This is Mario, isn't it? Yeah. Look at that. Oh. I don't know if I said this already, but the art style is cute. It makes up for the frankly basic character models, I think, at least. Today is the flower festival. You should go in and join the festivities. Personally, I'd have gone with more of a cel-shaded look, but that's more of a personal thing. Also, the thumbs need work, but who's gonna be looking at thumbs when you have so much adventuring to do? So much exploring. You wanna talk? Did you hear? Today's the annual flower festival. Actually, let's go ahead and use this compass. Oh, I see. Proper Skyrim-y stuff. Now. Dope. Although I get the feeling that these people don't really know what a compass is, because this isn't really what compasses do. Let's go ahead and turn that off. I don't like it. I wish I could swim, but my poor little arms just aren't strong enough. Tweedledee. These guys have serious confidence problems. Like, believe in yourself, you fool. These turtles don't even have arms. And look at them, swimming. Swimming like it ain't nobody's problem. Also, they have eyebrows for some reason, which is a little bit weird, I'll be honest with you. But, you know, like, he has no problem with it. He's just like, yeah, whatever. I got eyebrows now. Deal with it. And deal with it we shall. Alright, so... what were we doing? Right, we're getting medallions. Yes, you're gonna see me do this again. There you go. It was easier that time, though. See, I'm learning. Oh shit. I freaked out there. I panicked. Alright, so I'm guessing here is where these little guys are having their flower festival, because that's just how boring these people are, really. This year's contest will begin once all three contestants are ready. Please help me find my seed. I think I lost it in a nearby cave. Okay. Please help find my seed. I think I lost it in a nearby cave. Interesting. Please help find my seed. I think I lost it in a nearby cave. What the hell were all you people doing in caves? Is there some sort of secret cult thing that I should be worried about? I don't trust them. I don't trust them one bit. New location, Fox Cave. Ooh. I'm gonna open that up a little bit. Clue. Okay, I don't know what a clue stone is, but I have items. Tons of items. I see. Okay, so these aren't missions. These are things to find. Well, that's cool. I like that. That's very, very cool. Thanks for finding my seed. I knew it was in that cave after all. Well, you're welcome. I'm happy to help. Because this game is adorbs. What was that? That monster and that voice did not seem... They didn't fit. Yeah. Okay, so they say the same things. Are you Flappy Bird? Yep. So, if I was to say one thing, it's that this game's terminology is kind of screwed up, because that's not really a location. If anything, that's a character, or animal, or something. It's fine. We'll do what we can. It's also worth noting that these things apparently have telepathy, because that's bizarre. How is he talking to me right now? Thanks for finding my seed. I knew it was in a cave after all. Nice. That was pro MLG stuff right there. Ha! Huh. Oh, I seemed to drop more coins that time. So, one of the interesting things is that the enemies seem like a tertiary concern at best. Which, thanks for finding my seed, I knew it was in a cave after all. Yeah. Yeah, they're a tertiary concern at best, at least right now. That may change in the future, but I kind of like that. I'll be honest with you. Like, as much as I like, you know, my violent stuff, it's nice to have a game that just isn't really bothered by it. You know, I could kill this guy or I could not. And I don't have to, it's not forcing me to, and, you know, really, aside from this one, which I do want to kill, I'll be honest, because, there you go. It's nice. It's nice to have just kind of a chill game where your goal isn't to eradicate all the life, but just sort of to explore. There you go. That was some ninja stuff. In fact, how did I do that side jump? Oh, shit. Yep. There you go. Classic Platforming is the name of that achievement. Yes, indeed. Can I talk to you? Hey, Fox. Oh. My God. That thing is a massive. I can't really. I wish I could pet you. That's okay. Haha. Mario. Let's talk to you. It's time. Yeah, I'm convinced that they're like cultists. They have to be. No normal person says, "It's time." Like that. Let the contest begin. Oh. And it looks like this year's winner is yellow. Well, obviously, look at that. And we hope to see you again next year. Enjoy the rest of the festival, everyone. Good lord, these people are dreary. Alright. This year's contest was a great success, and it's all thanks to you, Tweedledee. This year's contest was a great success, and it's all thanks to you, Tweedledee. So, oh my god, they're so dreary they can't even think of original things to say. It's officially complete. Good. I'm guessing these things are platforms or something that I need to worry about. Yep. Look at that. Bam. She doesn't seem as happy as the boy type. Well, that's okay. She's more just proud of herself. She's like, yeah, that's right, I did it. Listening to her conch. Welcome back, Explorer. You seem to have a visitor off our port side. Take a look. Ooh. I wonder if they're friendly. You should go find out. How will you get over there? Here, use my old Explorer sail. The Explorer sail will let you soar through the sky. I've hooked it up to your backpack, so just jump off the airship and it will activate immediately. I don't know where airship came from. I guess I just filled in words in my head. Has it ever failed to activate? Not yet. Heh-hoo. Fair enough. Go on, now jump off the ship and investigate our new visitor. So, remember what I said about enemies not really being a priority? I might be wrong, because I saw a pirate ship. And, nice. On the other hand, oh, okay, there you go. Not really how parachutes work, but you know what? I'm enjoying this. This is fun. There you go. Who are you? You don't look all that friendly. No, but I guess he is. Meet the merchant. Ahoy there, you must be one of those explorer folk. I'm a traveling merchant. In exchange for coins, you can borrow my cannon to visit far-off lands. Ooh. Oh. This is interesting. So are these, like, challenge levels, then? Alright. Let's try the puzzle tower. Yeah. I like the way he waves. I should wave like that. Oh, very nice. Very, very nice. Oh, I'm timed. Climb to the top. Find the hidden ladders to make my way up. Kind of reminds me of Harry Potter in a way, the staircase and all that. Okay, let's go ahead and keep climbing. I probably need to go that way, but let's see if there's anything over here. Oh yeah, I'm missing all kinds of coins. That's like the most important thing. Oh shoot. Right. Okay. So that's tricky. Ah. Gotcha. I should probably sprint more, actually. There you go. That probably was gonna push me right off. Oh god. That was faster than I thought. But I made it. Look at me, solving the first challenge level. Being unduly proud of myself. In a minute and 15 seconds, don't you know? Very nice. So, I'm 128th, which is a good thing. Because that means at least 128 people are playing this game, and so far as I'm concerned, it deserves to be played. Oh, sorry. Probably don't want to be looking at that, but I'll get rid of that in post. loading the sky. Oh, it's darker now. What's this thing? It's just a campfire. Okay.
Hey.
Back with more coin. Have a look. Well, maybe not wheel. It depends on how many of you people like watching this, but I'll definitely do that later. Because this game is rad. Bam. Let's go ahead and switch to the boy type really quick. And have a look-see at... Actually, let's buy some equipment. What should we buy? I'm thinking shovel. And are you all in agreement? Yes? No? You wouldn't be able to have an input because of how I'll be producing these? Fair enough. We'll buy the shovel. Use the shovel to dig for treasure and fossils. Try digging in a lot of places. You won't be able to dig on hard surfaces, however. Makes sense. To use an explorer tool, use LT and RT to select the tool, then press Y to use it. Gotcha. Rocket blast off, Cozy Canyon. Let's do this. Oh, I almost forgot. Hehu. Take my old explorer book. I forgot to give it to you on the airship. I've had this. I've had it for a good while. But, okay. Items, clue stones. There's more stuff in the forest. I know I saw that for a while. I know I've been looking at that for a while, but for some reason it kind of slipped my mind. Eight out of 16. I don't know what these are. Oh, fossils. Right. It contains my old notes on where I found those explorer medallions. To open up the explorer book, press a back. Good luck. Thank you. So, I know this is... Oh, you can roll on them as well. Delightful. You found a dig site. Equip your shovel using LT and RT and use Y to dig. You'll probably find some rare treasure, so keep an eye out for other dig sites. Okay. Ooh. Fossil found. Trilobite. Trilobites are cool. Interesting little animals. They look like horseshoe crabs, and horseshoe crabs are also quite cool little animals. Let's record each fossil you find in your explorer book. I've heard that there is an archaeologist in Mount Magma who is looking for them. Ooh. We might want to find him. Maybe he can help us find the explorer medallions. Maybe he can. Everybody seems infatuated with them. And let's go this way because we haven't gone this way the last couple of times. And I feel it's being probably feels neglected. These guys sound delightful. Oh, mistimed that. Collect the coins. Look at that. Ninja stuff again. I don't really know how I do it though. There you go. Kind of just like snap the stick back and jump. All right. Again, little things, like that should have had sound effects. It really should have. But that's okay. God, I'm falling apart. I can't video games anymore. Jump on him twice, that's fine. I think it's the rain is messing me up now. But yeah, so there are little things, definitely, that I would say, even though it is out of early access, still needs, or still could use, a bit of love. Which way? Was the rocket this way? Okay, so I guess the microscope or telescope might have been handy. Who knows? We'll go this way. I know I have a compass. But, Jesus. I have a compass, but... Oh my god! There you go. That's what I wanted to do. I have a compass. Oh, but... I kind of just like running around a bit. Although I know that's not the most compelling viewing material, so... Oh, that's... What's the wrong button? I'll turn it on. Oh yeah, dig site. There you go. Look at that. Got ourselves a crusty Asian. Presumably some sort of crab. I'm not gonna bother with you because you're probably saying the same exact things. My objective down there. Oh no, that's just a point of interest. Okay. Boom, look at that. Pro platforming right there. And that was a pedestal in which I found some stuff. Some seed. There you go. Look at that. The gaming is back. Oh, it's probably over there. Oh, where that glow is. I almost lost the gaming there for a bit. Bam. Out of here. You done, son. Get the coin. Thank you kindly. Actually, how much health do I have? Am I almost dead? Probably. Let's see here. So there's a fossil over there somewhere. Point of interest over here. This kid is on the ropes. He is not too happy about that. And, as much as I love subjecting you guys to platforming goodness, I might cut out here and get back to you when I actually get to something worth showing. Yeah, I'll do that. Alright, so I'm back and I see the rocket ship over here and a whole new area-ish, I mean. Over here is the old stuff. Oh, fossil! Fossil found. Dusty shell. Excellent. It's not really a fossil, but I'll let that slide. Anyways, new place to look at. Isn't that wonderful? So, let's go ahead and do that. Bees over here. Looking charming. This guy. Probably contemplating how weak and ineffectual he is. You can use the metal climbing grates to climb back up. Oh, look at that. None of the usual, oh, but I never could do that, that I get from his ilk. There you go. I gotcha. And checkpoint. How about that? Okay. It's one of those things that you can tell was kind of made on a budget, right? Like, that's not... Doesn't look great, that, but it's okay. I keep saying that, I keep like making excuses for it basically, but... But you know what? I found the Lighthouse Cove, so how can I be mad at it? How indeed. There you go. And over here is that a rocket ship. So, If I can just jump over there on that little spring. Is there falling damage? We'll find out. No. No, there is not. Well, why would there be falling damage in a 3D platformer? Pray tell. Alright. There you go. Fossil found. Fractured fin. Oh, not bad. Completely intact, too. There it is. But those pillars just can't support my weight, Tweedledee. Of course. There's been like two of them that believe in themselves. The rest are all very, very negative. New location, super spaceship. Oh, hello there, young explorer. You seem to be stuck on this small island. Well, shucks. I was working on my mission when a part of my spaceship fell off. Now I can't seem to find it. Can you help me find the missing part so I can continue on my mission? Sure. Great. I've added the tracking beacon to your compass. You should be able to see it when you get nearby. Well, good. Isn't that lovely? Okay, so these... This is interesting. There it is. Oh! New location, explorer on a wire. I flubbed that a little bit, but I found this fossil, so who can stay mad about that? Moonfish rock. Interesting. Can't say I've ever heard of a moonfish. Heard of a sunfish. Is that just one of those things that's indigenous to the land of Poi? So, this used to work. There it is. Bit odd when it decides... I can also double jump. I forgot that I had that. But, you know, what was I saying? A bit odd when it decides that the super jump works. Alright, so we'll... Is that not a checkpoint? I guess not. That's alright, we'll get this fossil going. Cosmos fragment. Ooh, very nice. Right. There you go. Oh shit! I turned right to it because I knew that it was moving. That was stupid of me. That was very stupid of me. Nope. There you go. Got the heart. And got that guy. So they can eat all of... Oh, there's the rocket ship thing as well, too. Good. It was obscured a little bit by my mic. So I wasn't really paying attention to where I was going for a while. But no, it's right there. Oh, I'm like right on top of it. Yep, there it is. Nice. Thanks for helping me out, friend. I barely know you. Now I can continue my mission of mapping the world. If you'd like, I can give you a ride in my spaceship. Just jump on in. Thanks for helping me. Yeah. Let me jump. Oh. Suddenly we're in Super Mario Galaxy. I like how the orbits are clearly displayed. And this guy has a space helmet and I don't? Oh, what on earth? Did you notice these creatures roaming around here? I've been studying them for years to find out where they came from. They seem to be able to survive anywhere. So do I, apparently. Oh. Oh, the gravity's different too. That's cool. I like that. I am all for that. I say that this was like Super Mario Galaxy. It's actually a little bit more like... Yeah, they can survive anywhere, but they can't survive me. Anyways, what was I saying? It's a little bit more like Ratchet and Clank, if I'm being honest. The first one was really big on these types of... I think it was the first one that did this, these moon missions. Or maybe it was the second... No, it was the second one that did it. And I don't know... I don't quite remember if the third one continued it. I don't think it did. I think the third one was more focused on, like, those, like, militia missions or whatever they were called. Which were also fairly neat in their own way, but I don't know. I missed the moon. The moons were fun. That's okay, because now I have Poi to fill in that... to fill that hole in my heart. That's not anything I can get to. At least I don't think so. Unless I do the... Oh yeah, that could make it easy. There you go. Let's just get the keys though for now, and then we'll call it. An episode. So let's just keep it centered. We'll come up to it eventually, I'm sure. Huh! I'm wearing a little helmet as well. That's cute. Which makes it all the more damning that I don't have one. Really. Can explorers just survive off sheer charisma? Okay. 5 out of 5. And now we got the Explorer's Medallion. So let's go ahead and get that then. Oh! Oh, that's cool. I guess if you get high enough, you can just fly. Well, that makes it way... That's way easier. And, not to mention, a badass. Alright, medallion collected. Rocket blast off. Took me 17 minutes to do that. I'm sure you're all dying of boredom right now, so I am going to call that good. I mean, I hope you're not dying of boredom, because I had a bit of fun. And I will probably be playing this more. Like I said, it just came out, so if you have a PC and you've been dying for these sorts of games, waiting for, you know, ukulele and all that sort of stuff to kick in, it's like $12 right now, and I would say I don't regret the purchase. It is not bad at all. So, yeah, that's good. And I will see you guys later. Bye.